CGM sensor failure, the recurrent most common problem in today's insulin pump and diabetes technology. If you're watching this video because that's what you're dealing with, your situation is probably worse than what is shown here, because in this case, the sensor reading was only not available for 1 minute, which you can see there because in the corner it says exit in 3 hours, 59 minutes. This is the MiniMed 780G insulin pump. And it, if you are in smart guard mode, it starts counting down from 4 hours as soon as it does not have a signal. 1 minute is no big deal. It happens fairly frequently. It's kind of annoying, but you just press that arrow button and you can see the graph of what your blood glucose has been doing. Probably though, you're running into issues where there's no sensor signal for a longer time. Like this one, in this photo, it was about 14 minutes of no sensor reading. Sometimes you might see the X symbol on the transmitter symbol at the top of the screen as well. This is not an urgent situation unless you don't have another way to check your blood sugar and you're going low. But generally, as long as you can check your blood sugar with a blood glucose meter, it's not urgent because the insulin pump will continue giving you insulin. In smart guard mode, it will do that for 4 hours. And then after 4 hours, it will switch into manual mode and it'll give you insulin based on the manual mode settings. So not an emergency. You'll still get the insulin, but you might not get exactly the right amount of insulin because it doesn't know what your sensor reading is. So you might need to make some adjustments. You might also see searching for sensor signal. You might see lost sensor signal, which says move pump closer to sensor. It might take 15 minutes to find the signal. And then when you look at the graph, it might be that there's nothing, no information on that graph. Quick fixes to try. Number one, move the pump to the same side of the body as the sensor. Sometimes it just, for whatever reason, the waves that are going through the air to connect wirelessly between your sensor and your insulin pump need to be closer together. The other thing to do is drink water, because staying hydrated means that the sensor will be able to work better. Don't drink just coffee. Coffee is a diuretic, and a diuretic will actually make you lose water. So drink water, stay hydrated, and then wait 5 minutes and check again. The CGM only updates every 5 minutes. In a lot of cases, the sensor issues are temporary, and you'll end up with a working sensor by just drinking some water, waiting a little bit of time, or moving the location of your insulin pump closer to your sensor. These two tips can help with your CGM sensor no matter which sensor you use. The MiniMed 780G insulin pump does have several different CGM sensors it's compatible with. All these sensors do have some sensor warm-up time in the beginning, either 1 or 2 hours. So it's normal to not have a CGM sensor reading for the first one or two hours after you start your sensor. These are the three CGM sensors that are currently available for the MiniMed 780G insulin pump. The Instinct sensor has a 1 hour warm-up time, unlike the other two that are 2 hour warm-up time. And then the Guardian 4 sensor is different because it has a separate transmitter that you connect to the sensor, and the transmitter is reusable, where the other sensors are all in one. And that's important here because if you're using the Guardian 4 transmitter, if you are having sensor issues, there's some additional steps you can try to take to see if you can resolve the issue, whereas the other two sensors are all in one, so you can't disconnect it from a transmitter. The downside of the Guardian 4 sensor, if you're trying to decide which sensor to use, it is a two-handed insertion requirement, whereas the other ones are just one-handed. So it's helpful if you have somebody that can help you insert it, although you can, a lot of people can insert the sensor fine on their abdomen. I also put the sensor in my outer thigh, which is not an officially recommended place to put the sensor, but it does work well for me. The Instinct and Simplera Sync sensors are a bit smaller, and those are the newer options here, and people are very excited about that. I've been using the Guardian 4 sensor for the last few years. And then before that, the Guardian 3 sensor, and it's very accurate for me, but there are some trade-offs. It is only a 7-day sensor, and it's usually the first day where there's the most difficulties, problems with getting a sensor reading. And I have some tips on what I do to try to resolve that issue. So on the first day, sometimes you can get this sensor updating thing, which is really annoying. I mean, you could get the sensor updating message any day, but on the first day, it's more likely to get it. And so you can go through sensor warm-up of 2 hours for the Guardian 4 CGM sensor and then go into sensor updating for several more hours, which can be like half of a day without getting any CGM sensor reading, which definitely makes managing your blood sugar more challenging. You might get this message, sensor updating. Updating can take up to 2 hours. Monitor BG, telling you to monitor your blood glucose with a blood glucose meter. Make sure you always have a blood glucose meter that is working with glucose strips that are not expired. One thing with this insulin pump is because you do not need to calibrate it, you actually don't end up testing your blood sugar very often, and it's really easy to have your blood glucose strips get expired, which is what happened to me. So it's a great idea to make sure you always replenish with more glucose test strips. Probably the most critical thing you can have in your diabetes arsenal is have the blood glucose meter for when the CGM sensor does not work. So you might see sensor updating, really annoying. Well, there's something I do. I try this marinating thing to resolve issues with the sensor on the first day. So what I do is I put the new sensor under my skin like the night before. I don't start using it. I don't connect the transmitter to it. I just let the sensor sit under my skin and my body fluids. And I think that letting it sit there for about 6 to 8 hours is what helps it work better on the first day and avoid all the sensor updating issues. So 6 to 8 hours beforehand, you do the first thing, you put the new sensor in, but you don't switch to it. You continue to use your old sensor. And then when you're ready to switch to the new sensor, you connect the transmitter and start the new sensor then. For me, that avoids all of these issues on the first day. Like, it's amazing how much of a difference this makes. And credit to the Facebook group about this insulin pump for that great idea. This is not my idea. I learned so much from other users of this insulin pump. They talk a lot about marinating, solving this first day issue with the Guardian CGM. If you get repeated issues, you should definitely contact Medtronic MiniMed. The number is on the bottom. Not button, it's on the bottom of your pump. they would love to hear from you if you keep having issues, because they really don't want you to leave to another, switch to another company, and they want to help you out. And they can walk you through the best things to do. One thing that they have done when I called them when I had an issue is they had me disconnect the transmitter from the sensor, which you can only do if you have the Guardian one, since this transmitter is a separate piece from the sensor. And then you place the transmitter back on the charger and then try to reconnect after a few minutes to your sensor. And if that doesn't work, sometimes they also have you unpair the transmitter completely from your insulin pump and then repair it, sort of like a reset. So many things in technology, it's about restarting the system. So there's instructions on Medtronic's website about how to do this pairing, and that might help you out. However, if you keep getting a lot of issues where it says sensor updating or change sensor before the 7-day time period, definitely talk to Medtronic. There might be something wrong with your transmitter. You might need a new transmitter. The transmitter only lasts for 1 year. It has a rechargeable battery. Well, the warranty is good for 1 year. It might actually last longer than 1 year, but you don't want it to suddenly go out on you and stop working. So it's best to get a new transmitter as soon as you're out of warranty there, so that you have a backup transmitter. So when the transmitter fails, which it will fail someday, you have a new one, and then you're not without. This is such critical medical technology. If you do get a change sensor error message, definitely change the sensor and put a new sensor in. And also, you can go to Medtronic's website and request a replacement, and they've always replaced my sensors when they don't last the full 7 days. Just go to diabetes.shop. Diabetes.shop is their website, and you can replace get the sensor replaced free of charge. They will also replace the battery cap, the belt clip, and there's a few other things here. I'm sure it will be changing by the time you watch this video if it's been a while. But great, diabetes.shop. Log into your account there, and then you can get that free replacement sensor. My experience of connectivity issues is that I'm more likely to have an issue at a few certain circumstances. If I have an electric blanket over me, the interference from the electricity in that blanket apparently can cause a connectivity issue. If I have the laptop on my lap and my insulin pump is on one side of my body and the sensor is on the other side of my body, that can also cause an issue. After taking a shower, so I disconnect when I take a shower and I set the insulin pump aside, but often when I come out of the shower, the insulin pump does not have a CGM sensor reading. I'm not quite sure why that is, but once I reconnect to me, and I put my clothes on, I'm done showering. It seems to come back within a few minutes. It's not a big deal, but it does usually happen then. And then also sitting on concrete, the concrete steps, like what's shown in that picture there. The concrete is great at soaking up radio waves. So you might find there's particular things that are likely to cause a sensor issue. Or maybe you're just, when you're dehydrated, if there's some time where you don't drink enough water, you might get a sensor issue. If you found this information about the CGM sensor helpful, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up, a like on the video. And if you would like to subscribe, I am going to need insulin for the rest of my life, most likely, because I have Leda diabetes, which is a subtype of type 1 diabetes, and I've gone past the honeymoon time period, and my pancreas is not functioning correctly. So I will be sharing more information when things progress and as new technology comes out. So subscribe to get insight from me. I have other videos here. If you were just thinking about the 780G insulin pump, please don't let this scare you, because it's a really a good insulin pump, and this issue is something that doesn't happen too often, especially if you are using the Guardian 4 and you're marinating like I am. That's not, it's very, very reliable. And there are three different CGM sensors to choose from now. From what I've heard, what people have been telling me, that people have different experiences than my own, depending on the sensor. So it's always good to get a lot of opinions out there, and also just tell Medtronic if something's not working out, because there's probably other options. It's hard to believe that there was a time where people were using insulin pumps and they did not have a CGM. They didn't have any of this automatic correction. So we've come a really far long way, but it also can be really stressful whenever diabetes technology stops working. So it's good to know what you can do in a situation like that, and always have backup supplies with you, and talk to your doctor about getting a backup insulin in case your insulin pump stops working as well. It's very important. And plus, if you get some extra backup insulin, then if something just comes up where you run out of insulin for some reason, you have some more on hand. Always good to be prepared for emergencies. So what's your experience? Do you use the Guardian 4 CGM? Do you use the Simplera Sync or the Instinct CGM? Why? Which sensor do you use? Do you like it better than the one you have used before? I'd love to hear from you if you have changed to a different sensor. I'm sure people are really curious, because these other sensor options are pretty new. So please comment and share what's going on. And I think other people will read this too. And it's a good way to get the word out if you are having troubles with this technology, because we need very reliable diabetes technology. It's really unfortunate that it's not more reliable. I am hoping that it's just going to improve and be uphill from here. With AI, you would think that they could really make some excellent technology that is 100% reliable and adaptive to your body, right? That's one of the great things about the time we live in right now. Let's see AI put to good use that saves lives and relieves stress and all the good things that technology, medical technology can do. I've been using an insulin pump for about 5 years now. Check out my website, insulinpumplife.com. Thank you.